1, 2, 3, 4.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour, brought to you by Carroll County Fresh. I'm your host, Dan Croats. Today's broadcast is on April 14th, 2012. This is show number 7 of Season 3. We're coming to you from high atop the Grand View Hotel in downtown Berryville and looking down on the little town in the Ozarks that time didn't forget, but has treated nicely anyway. We hope you'll come and visit us if you're not a local resident. We have a busy, busy show today. First up is an interview with Robert Butch Berry, who is running in District 97 for state representative. District 97, in case you don't know, runs south from the Missouri border and almost all the way to Springdale on the west, and then down south past Wesley, and then coming back up a bit east of Berryville. Butch is a Democrat. He's from Eureka Springs. And we'll have his opponent, who will be either Bob Bollinger or Jeremy Miller, on the program after the May 22nd Republican primary. Our good friend Richard Hsu, the creator of Wintertainment and a fine poet, is on our program today. We confidently call Richard a founding father of Eureka Springs, one of those hardy souls who arrived in that town as hippies in the 1970s. And grew up and went on to form its current day soul and spine. Richard will tell us a bit about his life and times, and he recites some really fun and interesting poems. I had a good time talking with Richard. He's a neat guy. Richard and Jane Pillay are on the show with us today with the first of the season's In the Garden essays. Richard will be sharing the mic with me later on this season as co-host, and we look forward to hearing him do lots of readings for us. Some of those will include stuff by Wendell Berry and some other folks that Richard has dubbed too radical for words. Many thanks for your emails this past week. Melissa Yant of Traverse City, Michigan writes in to say, "Thank you for having Debbie Quigley Smith on your program. I really loved her poems. I'm a farmer, and they really show that she understands what it means to grow things. I'm definitely coming to Eureka Springs this summer, and I will visit Quigley Castle so that I get the chance to meet her. Thank you, Debbie, for everything you do." And we thank you, Melissa, for writing in. Richard Catalini from Mountain Home, Arkansas says, "Keep up the good work, Dan. You're not much to listen to, but I did enjoy your interview with Jerry Landrum from the Echo Village. You rednecks are way ahead of us in the appropriate technology world." Thank you, Richard, for your kind words. By the way, and just for the record, Mr. Catalani, we prefer to be called Appalachian Americans. Some folks think that redneck is hurtful. Later in the program, we'll share information about the 2012 Carroll County Fresh Photography Contest. We have some farmers market news, including the fact that Robin Latham up at Holiday Island has got the Holiday Island Farmers Market up and running. Okay, friends, let's now hear from Butch Berry, candidate for the House of Representatives in District 797. Robert Butch Berry, who many people know from his work as an alderman on the Eureka Springs City Council and as mayor pro tem of that city for four terms, is running for the State House of Representatives in District 97 against either Bob Bollinger from Berryville, Arkansas, or Jeremy Miller from Clifty, Arkansas. We'll have Mr. Ballinger or Mr. Miller on the program when we find out who wins the Republican primary runoff on May 22nd. But we've been lucky enough to have Butch show up today. Butch Berry, welcome to the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour.
Well, thank you for inviting me. I'm looking forward to the interview and discussing some of the issues that come up.
All right. Butch, I don't know very much about you, having spent most of my Arkansas life on the east side of the Kinks River. But tell us a bit about you and your roots here in Carroll County.
Well, I was born in Eureka Springs a little over 60 years ago, to date myself, in the local hospital. Grew up in Eureka Springs, went through school most of my years in Eureka, but ended up graduating out of Berryville in 1967.
Okay, so you're a graduate of Berryville High School?
I'm a graduate of Berryville High.
All right. Well,
and went from there on to college and ended up getting a degree in architecture from the University of Arkansas at Fayetteville in 1973. And moved back to Eureka Springs to take care of my grandmother. I was raised by my grandmother. My mother on the Price side is a fourth generation Carroll Countian.
Uh-huh.
We actually, on the Price side, were there when the town was established in 1876.
Oh, my goodness.
And
you've been around for a while.
Well, the Prices have. That's true.
Okay. Very good. Very good.
And my mother was killed in a car wreck, though, when I was 18 months old. And so my grandmother raised me. And then my father, who was in the Air Force, passed away. Actually died in the Air Force when I was 8 years old. So
uh-huh.
I ended up being raised by my 70-year-old grandmother.
All right. Wow. And Butch, are you a working architect?
I am a working architect.
All right.
I'm not sure what that means, but I definitely work at being an architect.
Uh-huh.
And
all right.
Moved back to Eureka Springs. I spent some time in Little Rock. I was my last position was in state government. I was the executive director for the Capital Zoning District Commission. For the state of Arkansas, which is a combination planning and zoning and historic district commission that
okay.
reviews everything around the governor's mansion and the state capitol.
All right, all right. Well, many years ago, I got a degree in planning from the University of Minnesota, so I think I probably know a little bit about what you're doing down there. Thank you for doing that. But in your mind, what are the issues that confront voters in District 97?
Well, in my opinion and from my experience, what we do need is some method of working with small businesses, creating opportunities for small business in the area. We have a diverse economy. Probably one of the more diverse areas than any other district in Arkansas. We have Eureka Springs, which is a tourist economy. We have a retirement community, not only in Eureka Springs, but Holiday Island. And then we come over to Berryville, where we have a more of an industrial, rural district. And then we get into, and also we have the farming and the agricultural, which is going around a lot of Carroll County and Madison County. And then we reach into the eastern edge of Washington County, which is more of an upscaled area that I think most of the people live in and around or commute into Springdale, Fayetteville, which is a more of an urban. In fact, it's one of the largest urban areas that we have in the state.
Yeah, District 97 goes north of Beaver. Just about up to the Missouri state line.
It goes to the Missouri state line.
Right, and then all the way south down to Wesley, and then west just about Springdale, and then east just a little bit past Berryville itself, right?
Correct, almost to Highway 412. It bypasses Huntsville, the town of Huntsville proper, but then goes on to Goshen and Hinesville, and it actually goes into the city limits of Springdale.
All right. So you do have a really diverse district to represent.
Yeah.
It is. It's got to be a challenge to meet the needs of so many different kinds of constituents, isn't it?
Well, it is. But I think again, some of the basic qualifications are. I think everybody's is interested in the jobs and bringing its jobs in. And my philosophy is, especially with the, we are such a small community, I think there's two issues. One, the areas around Huntsville and Berryville can certainly and do have a chance for the industrial area, industrial jobs. I recently went down to Mulberry, Arkansas, where the governor introduced a new soybean plant down there that was going to employ, I think, 60 people right off the bat, and then up to another 200 people to process a new type of soybeans that's being developed. And he did this off of a grant system and working with people from overseas. Actually, I know he was an Oriental going into the soybean industry.
Mm-hmm.
So hopefully working with the governor and developing a working relationship with a Democratic governor, we can bring some sort of industry up into Carroll County and Madison County. But I think it's also important for the small mom and pop organizations. Things like we have exported a lot of our jobs over the years. And there's jobs such as call forwarding and call services that could be applied to Carroll and Madison County, especially with the age of computer systems and high tech. You don't have to have these jobs located in Kansas City or Dallas or India. They could be in Clifty, Hinesville, Eureka Springs. So I think there's that opportunity too of reaching out and trying to bring in those type of jobs through some sort of tax incentives.
Okay, we're talking with Butch Berry, who is running for House of Representatives in District 97. We'll be back after this break.